1965 was such a great year for pop music, with the numerous TV shows that featured all of the top talent of the day, including Hullabaloo, Shindig, Hollywood A-Go-Go, Shivaree, Where the Action Is, and of course hundreds of local shows. And on many of those national TV shows, a young man gained fame when he started singing his songs that seemed to hit home with everyone. One in particular talks about the guy that traveled the Rod. Mr. Roger Miller sang about the king of the road.
Sailor for sale I rent, rooms to let 50 cents. No phone, no food, no pets. Ain't got no cigarettes out of 2 hours of pushing broom. Buys a 8 for 12 for the room. Mama, man of means, final means. King of the road.
In 1965, the man that had started it all, Elvis Presley, made what some call the comeback. To others, his loyal fans, he was just doing what he had always done, making millions selling records.
Slowly crying in the child.
By getting down to the nitty-gritty of things. And in 1965, Shirley Ellis scored again with the name game.
The name game.
Too many a broken heart. And in 1966, Jimmy Ruffin delved into the situation and asked what became of the broken heart.
Four young men. They created four monsters.
four men who took over television, records, and tore it up whenever they made a personal appearance. They started it all off in 1966 and carried over into 1967, when the Monkees recorded
"I'm Gonna Saw Her Face."
Remember it, that was Napoleon the 14th. 1966, another great year for instrumentals. One of the biggest was taken from a commercial on television. It was done by a studio group at Liberty Records in Hollywood. No matter what shape your stomach's in. When they relive the days of World War I. By Simon and Garfunkel, spanning 2 years, called The Sounds of Silence. The number three song was recorded by a young man who had been touring with the Beatles, a soft-spoken young man who wound up with the number three record of the year. His name, Bobby Hebb. His song,
"Thank You for That Smile Upon Your Face."
Another vocal group wowed the fancy of American music listeners. They were called the Lovin' Spoonful, and their song was "Summer in the City." He became the darling of the housewife set, and every day Mama would sit down in front of the television set and listen to him talk, interview guests, and sing. And when he sang, sometimes he brought tears to the eyes of his listeners.
There's a boy outside. His name is Eddie.
Yes, Father? Oh, can we borrow the car, Pop?
The man in my little girl's life. The man in my little girl's life.
Mike Douglas. In 1966, the story of the world that tears us apart. Every day we go to work, and at 5 o'clock, we find our own world. The Bulls sang about it. Oh.
Oh. in the history of music. Pop Goes the Music, an exclusive presentation of the Public Affairs Department of WCFL, the voice of labor, Chicago.